customers out the door every day, or your establishment looking like a ghost town is based on the experience.
No. Keith Lee? Motherfucking got that. Infinity Gauntlet.
...of one man. That one man is not a professional food critic nor a culinary expert, but millions of people around the country treat his word like gospel. That is the Keith Lee effect. Keith Lee is either Batman or Joker when it comes to restaurant owners. But once you hear his story...
If you think about it, it's not his fault. It's really not this man's fault. It's not his fault at all.
You will understand why he has such a cult-like following.
Really,
it's much
him.
Deeper than a guy who has decent taste buds. You know, Keith Lee is a man who failed at the...
Would I be considered a Swiftie? I'll fuck with like a couple 6, 7, 8 songs.
One thing he was actually good at. Then at his darkest moment, he refused to give up and created a meteoric influence in an industry he had no business being in. Keith described himself as a very small child who felt the need to display his dominance to overcompensate for his short stature. His bad behavior led to him getting expelled from every school in the Detroit, Michigan area before attending a charter school as a last resort, where he barely managed to graduate the 8th grade.
So by the time I got to high school, I was a weed head, smoking every day. I'm talking about bad, like every day. My freshman year, I had a 0.6 GPA.
Things would get even worse.
Chad, how you spell exquisitely?
Worse for Keith in high school, where he lived in the shadow of his brother. Keith's older brother Kevin had already garnered a remarkable reputation as a star athlete who graduated with a 3.9 GPA before receiving a scholarship to wrestle for Grand Valley State University, which is an NCAA Division II school. Keith decided to follow in his brother's footsteps for all the wrong reasons.
When I got there, it was more out of spite, it was more out of arrogance, it was more out of just like, now I'm approved to you, I can do it. And I don't even want to do it. I'm going to just do it because you told me I can't do something else. So I'm going to just do it just to shit on you, basically.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
He utilized all his pent-up aggression and transferred it out on the wrestling mat, where he showed a genuine talent for the sport and squashed his competition. But he was a stubborn, disobedient child who didn't focus on...
Ooh, he's a thug.
On his grades, didn't stay disciplined, and quit the team. Then his father got arrested and imprisoned following a heated altercation with some people in his neighborhood. His father's inability to provide for his family meant Keith, his mother, and younger brother were forced to move into an abandoned home where Keith started to question his religious faith and overall perspective on life. At his
level, how does this nigga, fuck, what's his name? Patrick CC know all this, bro. I know he got a team. He does not. It's just not him.
At this moment, the only way he could go was up. He stopped smoking, stopped hanging out with bad influences, and got back into wrestling. Fast forward to his senior year, Keith averaged a 3.6 GPA and was preparing to wrestle at the Michigan High School State Championships, which hadn't been achieved by a student at Southfield High School since the 90s. He received a partial scholarship to wrestle for Indiana Tech, but made a critical error. He never actually enrolled in the school. He showed up at Indiana Tech, connected with the wrestling coach, attended random classes, and got fully immersed into the college life. He was expecting a dorm room since he thought he had a scholarship, but when he showed up to the admissions office, they were confused.
They take me to the office and they like, you don't have no paperwork filled out, sir.
Who are you?
Yeah, they was like, only thing we have is the offer letter that we sent you.
What?
So we only got your name and your information from the offer letter. They was like, that's all we know about you. We don't know nothing else.
He treated it like a birthday party invitation. You sent me the invitation.
I just showed up.
Keith laughs about the situation now, but at the time, he was devastated. They told Keith if he didn't pay them $20,000 for the semester and $2,000 for the application fee, he wouldn't be allowed to go to school. Unable to get a loan, Keith had to move back with his family, who relocated to Las Vegas. He was now sharing bunk beds with his 14-year-old brother, who regularly reminded Keith that he was a loser.
At this point, I'm in the deepest depression I've been in a long time.
Dang.
Because I'm like, oh, reality is sitting in.
Yeah,
I'm not in school. I don't have a job. I got fired already. I didn't quit a job. My track history with work is already terrible. I didn't got kicked out of school.
Yeah.
I don't have no other offers.
Right.
Nothing in life is looking bright to me right now.
Right.
I don't have nothing going for me.
Keith's older brother Kevin had recently secured a contract to fight in the UFC as Kevin the Motown Phenom Lee, and Kevin was a savage. At his peak, he held a 16-2 professional record and was toe-to-toe with legends like Tony Ferguson and Charles Oliveira. Kevin forced Keith to get into the gym with him, and on his first day, their coach Dewey Cooper realized the potential Keith had as an MMA fighter. Desperate for money and a purpose, Keith trained...
Keith wasn't that good, though. I don't think he was. I remember he had some wins, but...
For a year straight and won his first four amateur fights. The only two losses he had were by split decision, meaning he was a very promising prospect. Yeah. However, he was earning next to nothing for these.
Damn.
500, maybe...
Now, when I say he wasn't good, I'm not going to challenge that nigga on the street. That nigga beat him my ass. No cap.
$1,000 per fight.
I'm not... challenging that nigga. That nigga, bro.
Keep in mind, this was over the course of 3 years, so he was broke following a rotation of various low-end jobs. But luckily, he met his girlfriend, now wife, Ronnie, while working for ASICS. Keith credits Ronnie with being the anchor to keeping him grounded and focused on becoming the best version of himself. Following a submission victory against Leonardo Carvalho at Global Legion FC 13, Keith proposed to his girlfriend Ronnie and intentionally got her pregnant 2 days later. On the same day of the proposal, Keith's manager informed him that his victory against Carvalho earned him a six-figure contract with Bellator. He won his very first Bellator bout against Sean Bunch. It took many years, but once he finally had a support system around him, wife, coaches, brother, he was able to crawl out of the repetitive cycle of depression and low ambition. Now with some free time and spare income, Keith signed up for TikTok. Keith's journey on TikTok started just like anyone else, participating in trends for no reason other than it seemed fun. From there, his uploads were just random things that pertained to his everyday life. He was getting maybe 50 views per video, but it seemed more like an outlet for him to have fun rather than start a business. But then the pandemic hit, the world shut down, and Keith needed to make something happen.
I downloaded TikTok. I kept saying I wouldn't. Now I'm sick and tired of every video I post. Only getting 50 views. I'm gonna sit here with my dog.
It feel like everybody that get popular or famous on TikTok always starts this shit with, I wasn't gonna download TikTok. I thought TikTok was for weirdos. Then I tried it, and so-and-so.
And tip me and get famous.
In an attempt to garner more views, Keith began posting psychology facts videos. He gained a little bit of traction, but it didn't last long. He started to become desperate for virality.
You want to get famous? Follow these simple instructions. Download another motherfucking app, because this ain't the one. This ain't it, Chief. It ain't never gonna happen.
Never. He would cash app people if they solved a riddle. He posted math problems for people to solve. Even though he looked defeated, he refused to give up. At this point, Keith was obsessed with the platform, posting daily, if not multiple times per day. He started featuring his wife Ronnie on his page after he went semi-viral talking about building a nursery for their expected baby. He then proceeded to document milestones throughout their pregnancy, many of which received thousands of views and ignited a...
First video I remember was him doing... pregnancy cravings and Wingstop for Ronnie.
Traumatic shift in Keith's content. In September of 2020, Keith won his second fight against Vinicius Zani.
Whatever they have in store for me, I'm always here to fight. I'll fight as soon as my daughter's born. My daughter's born in 4 days, so as soon as she gets here, I'm ready to go again.
He didn't lie. Just 1 week later, he and Ronnie welcomed their first child, Carter. From there, Keith's whole TikTok was dedicated to documenting him being a parent. His loving and nurturing attitude towards his child attracted a large following of supporters. He provided them with wholesome moments, such as clipping his daughter's nails for the first time and celebrating her first Halloween. This was his family man era. Aww. Keith took a fight on short notice, just 2 months after his previous, to fight on the main card at Bellator 253. Unfortunately, he lost by decision to Rafion Stotts. But that didn't ruin his spirits. Keith the Family Man kept posting his terrible dancing videos and even started sprinkling in some cooking content. By mid-2021, he had accumulated 1 million followers and was averaging maybe 100,000 views per post. This was his foundation, the people that knew Keith was a humble, honest family man. Unfortunately, he would hit a new rock bottom when he lost his six-figure Bellator contract. In August of 2021, he was set to face his toughest opponent yet, who was undefeated. Keith was beaten and bloody and then submitted in just the first round, then got up while unconscious and stumbled headfirst into the cage. The clips of his loss made the rounds on social media. He was embarrassed. He got a call from his manager saying he was cut from Bellator. Keith was back to rock bottom. His first TikTok back after his loss was him, poetically, ordering some food.
I have these sunglasses on because my eyes black and my face is beat up. I'm fine though, for anybody. Well, I'm not fine, but I'll be fine.
He had 1 million followers, but he was only making around $400 per month on TikTok. His fight career was looking grim, and TikTok didn't seem realistic. Then he got a call from the owner of Harold's Chicken just a couple days after
the Chicago place.
His loss. They asked him to do a review of their establishment. At the time, he didn't know it, but Keith just discovered his next big venture.
All right, Harold's Chicken in Las Vegas. They didn't have no mac and cheese, but it's okay. Overall, I get a food of 9 out of 10.
Carol's is tough.
Without question.
Following,
I'm saying like I've been to Chicago and tried the food. Harold looks tough.
In his review of Harold's Chicken, Keith made food reviews as a side quest on his page. However, his main focus was on family vlogs and cooking content. He was still largely referred to as the cooking guy, regularly being asked about his cooking content during interviews. In January of 2022, his wife became pregnant with their second child, and they desperately needed to find another source of income. He started doing more and more food reviews, but they weren't that organized, and he was very generous with his ratings.
We are sitting outside of Firehouse's because today we are doing an official food review.
This has the perfect amount of spice. Like, my tongue is tingling a little bit. I got that feeling on my lips. You still taste all of it.
I think you can. I think you can try it, Jesse. Try it.
But a flavor. 10 out of 10.
Keith says he leaned on his faith and prayed something good would come from this TikTok thing. And it did. In June of 2022, he signed a brand deal with Wingstop worth six figures.
Brand the same deal. Amount. Yeah, that boy get money.
He had lost from the Bellator contract. He successfully was making a career on TikTok, but it was about to get a whole lot better.
Return of the Mac. Return of the Mac. These three TDs on Brown's defense. Mr. Unlimited got it under control. Ooh, I can read.
Would be, and I think I have an alter ego. His name's Mr. Unlimited.
Can't keep getting away with this. He can't keep getting
away with this. Russell was playing good this season on the Broncos. Then they made playoffs. I think they did.
His food reviews slowly started to become his main content because his brutal honesty was very entertaining.
Altogether, this food was $60 and the customer service was terrible. The lady at the front where I was picking up was really rude, like extremely rude.
I never heard Keith say that. Like, the customer service is really bad.
The lady at the front where I was picking up was
unless
really
it's
rude,
Atlanta.
Like, extremely rude. I had to call back and get her name. I think she lied because she answered the phone like I didn't recognize her voice and said, "Hold on, let me go get the girl. You the girl."
Then in October, the popular YouTube channel People
Versus. I was here around this time. He had like cool five games winning streak, but he did horrible. Like, yeah, I know he did terrible. Broncos country, let's ride. I know he did horrible last year.
Food.
I remember
approached
this.
Him to collaborate on their channel, and he accepted. This channel has over 12 million YouTube subscribers, and he knew the exposure would help his TikTok career immensely. That. By the way, double check if you're subscribed to my channel. I asked my wife what I should post on my page to make people not only come and watch, but actually follow, and we decided to post one full review every day. The first got like 11 million views. From there, Keith's entire content shifted to strictly food reviews. Yep. He has only been doing it full time for 1 year at this point, but he never could have predicted what was about to happen next. While most high profile food critics only pay attention to high end restaurants that are too expensive for most, Keith shifted that focus onto affordable, small, family owned restaurants
which
that were easily accessible to the public, or fast food slash popular affordable food chains. He even went out of his
came to oh my god bro came to Atlanta from Real Milk and Honey, got him fucked up
way to give a chance to establishments that were struggling financially. However, Keith doesn't consider himself a food critic. His reviews feel and look like one of your friends giving you a casual breakdown. A typical review would be him ordering three or four different items on the menu, like a family of four would, then tasting every single item and rating it from 1 to 10. He often throws in other notes like their customer service or additional information that is relevant to the experience.
I got it. Let's try it and rate it 1 through 10. I spent $23.84 on three bao buns and a drink. But bro, that's what they look like. Custom service, delightful. It was a very short interaction, but the guy who worked at the front was really nice. And the actual building itself,
man, of course they had to drug my RBJ.
Very aesthetically pleasing. It made me want to eat. Wait a minute, bro. Personally, it was lacking spice, so to add it a salsa, took the tacos itself from a 9 to a 9.7.
It's a little salty for me.
That's one of them ones.
Even when he gives a negative review to the food, he will provide more context so it doesn't come off as unfair.
But it's not even a fan base. Jonathan Taylor. Oh, wait, he got hurt. He did get hurt. But it wasn't last game. No, wait. I'm tweaking. I'm thinking of... Bro. He didn't get hurt. Injury. Oh, no, that was earlier. That was earlier in the season. I know it wasn't tweaking.
He often goes out of his way to leave massive tips, sometimes hundreds of dollars to workers that give him good service. Since he had already built a strong foundation during his Family Man era, there wasn't necessarily one viral review that changed his life. His growth has been steady, and along the journey, his audience latched onto his down-to-earth attitude, unwavering love for his wife and kids, and dedication to God. But even if you don't know about his past, after watching a few videos, you can just feel he is a kind and genuine man. They didn't care about Keith not being technically qualified nor having a depth of culinary knowledge. He thinks what sets him apart is his values. I stand on my integrity, I stand on my values, and I don't allow those to be wavered or to be shook no matter the amount of money, the opportunity, or the people
I'm
surrounded by. With nearly 10 million loyal followers, a full-time dedication to quality reviews of local or less popular restaurants, a phenomenon dubbed the Keith Lee effect would take over Las Vegas, then all over the USA. One of the first beneficiaries of the Keith Lee effect was a local food truck called 303 in the Cut. In November 2022, Keith's review blew up and garnered over 35 million TikTok views since its initial upload. Keith confirmed their cheesecake...
Chat, look. I got a beard. After Thanksgiving, you know what I'm saying?
Sandwich was a 10 out of 10. And the next night, 303 had people waiting in line for over an hour, wrapped around the corner for their food. The owner said they doubled their income in one day, and it stayed that way.
A food truck? Oh my God. A food truck?
For over a year. One Las Vegas pizzeria he reviewed, Frankenson's, made headlines for attracting lines around the block because Keith gave their wings a 10, pizza a 9.8, and garlic knots a 9.2. However, it wasn't just the food. It was Keith's interaction with the owner, Frank, that made people want to support him even more.
If I don't like the food, I gotta tell you, I'm not trying to be malicious. And he was like, I'm gonna be real with you too. I need help. Yeah, that hit me here. He said the food is delicious. He has great reviews on Yelp. The only bad reviews is that he don't close the time it says that he closed on Google. The time it says he closed on Google is 1 a.m. He was like, I literally can't afford to open that late because we don't get that much business. Frank, if you're watching this, I'm going to be completely honest. You are an amazing man. From what I saw. I appreciated your time and I appreciated your conversation. Let's try this food.
According to Frank, Frankenson's had to hire 23 new team members in the 6 weeks following Keith's review and had guests from all over the world patiently waiting for over 3 hours for his pizza. Frank said he was thankful that Keith helped his business and the overall community at large in Las Vegas. Yasser Zermino, owner of Aroma Latin American Cochina, asked Keith to come review their restaurant through email. Keith gave all 5 different items over a 9, including the Oaxaca sandwich, which he said was the best he had ever had in his life. The owner said, we went from not being able to pay the bills to now having
NBC
to hire people to come
of Keith Lee?
And help us. Other Vegas-based businesses that Keith reviewed have seen instant growth, like Caribbean restaurant The Pink Potato or Southern Taste Seafood, a food truck that went from making $200 or under a day to seeing a 900% increase in revenue in the days following Keith's review. But his impact wasn't just on small businesses. Even Chipotle, the fast casual chain that generated $8.6 billion in revenue in 2022, saw the benefits of the Keith Lee effect. In early 2023, a reviewer named Alexis Frost posted a review of a menu hack, an order of a steak quesadilla with extra cheese and fajita veggies that fans say tastes like a Philly cheesesteak. Keith reviewed it and gave it a 9.8. Then chaos ensued. Chipotle workers all over the country were overwhelmed with the tens of thousands of people coming in to order this hack. One employee said the worst shift of her life was servicing this trend. Another employee said a customer tried to swing on him, aka fight him, because
that's Chipotle, though. Chipotle. That's literally how Chipotle is. I ain't gonna lie. Well, over here, Popeye deadass might give you a better experience than Chipotle. I'm not even kidding.
Food. Managers started posting signs that say, protein and cheese on quesadilla only. Chipotle realized the only way to solve this problem was by adding the hack as an option on their menu, dubbed the Keithadilla. Keith quickly became well known all over Las Vegas. Once he partnered up with Mr. Beast to give $10,000 to a struggling business, he couldn't even go outside without being swarmed, so he dressed up in silly disguises to avoid being recognized. But his impact is not just in Vegas. Keith got to review a local Brooklyn bakery that he selected while being interviewed on Good Morning America, while also donating $10,000 $1,000 to that business. He continued to do press runs, being interviewed on talk shows around America, and of course, reviewing food. So now that we know how much positive impact Keith can have on a business when he likes the food, what about when he doesn't like the food? Well, unfortunately, the entire city of Atlanta would find out about the negative side of the
most definitely did.
Keith Lee effect. In October 2023, Keith announced to his nearly 15 million TikTok followers that he and his family were traveling to Atlanta, Georgia, and needed some restaurant recommendations. He had previously made videos in Detroit, Chicago, New Orleans, New York, and Los Angeles, but Atlanta's food scene is entirely different, which prompted a lot of mixed reviews from Keith. The drama first began when Keith visited the Atlanta Breakfast Club, where he wanted to take the food to go, but they didn't have anywhere to sit and wait for the food. So instead, they decided to dine in, but the restaurant wouldn't allow them to sit down at a table and be served unless the entire party was there. Upon finding out that they were charged $1 for butter at a breakfast place, it was just an annoying cherry on top.
$1 for butter?
Keith knew it was about to get worse. Keith posted his review of The Real Milk and Honey. However, he didn't.
That was the ice on the cream. Pause. Why did I say that? Cream on the ice? No. Icing on the cake. That's the saying.
Actually get any food. Firstly, he tried to call ahead and order. They don't accept call-ins. You can only order on the DoorDash app. But DoorDash said that they were closed. So they drove to the establishment in the middle of the day and the employees said they were closed for deep cleaning, while there were customers walking in and picking up orders. Then Keith walked into the restaurant and they recognized him and immediately attempted to serve him since he is famous, to which he declined. Keith has always been very expressive that he doesn't want nor deserve special treatment from restaurants. These days, he sends in his friends and family to do-
Oh my god, my- So fucking fine! Bro, Marzay! Marzay, she's so bad!
I will give you the world, baby girl. You just gotta be worth it. You just gotta be worth it.
Listen, Marzay, I will give you the world, baby girl. You just gotta be worth it.
But you don't gotta be perfect.
That was for you, Marzay. That's for you.
Do orders so he doesn't receive bias from the establishment. He wants his experience to match any ordinary person. I've personally never seen a restaurant have a rules list, but The Real Milk and Honey have a ton. We guarantee great food. Everything else is left to chance. We do not provide...
Nigga, what?
...at individual checks. 18% gratuity added to parties of five or more or checks larger... than $105. No reservations, unless you're Barack Obama. No parties larger than four on days that...
This can't be real. This can't be true. It gotta be like a...
...end in Y. Keith was clearly frustrated that a business would change the rules when it benefits them, but he didn't want people to attack The Real Milk and Honey because he had a bad experience. However, the internet, being the internet, started attacking. There was actually another restaurant called Milk and Honey whose owners were receiving death threats in the DMs because of people confusing them with the other restaurant. But if you had any sympathy for The Real Milk and Honey, it would be gone once you saw their response video they uploaded to TikTok.
Did you see this Keith Lee video about The Real Milk and Honey?
And who is this Keith Lee?
Daddy. You don't know Keith Lee?
Yeah.
No.
The owner tried to look cool and pretend like he didn't know the entirety of social media is destroying his business, but it only made people want to support their business less. To add insult to injury, Keith reviewed the bodega positively, which is directly next door to The Real Milk and Honey, which resulted in a line of...
Boy, Keith Petty, bro.
Customers skipping The Real Milk and Honey to wait in line for the bodega, but the shenanigans continued. Keith reviewed another ATL restaurant called Old Lady Gang, but again, did not get any food.
Yeah,
he tried to call their number,
experience.
No answer. tried to order on DoorDash, said they were closed. He sent his family into the physical store to do takeout. They said they don't do to-go orders on the weekends, but the wait to dine in was 1.5 hours and they didn't take reservations. Instead of leaving, Keith decided to walk in where he was recognized and immediately they offered him a seat, skipping the entire 1.5-hour wait, to which Keith denied because he didn't want any celebrity treatment. This is exactly how it is for us regular ATL folks.
No, it is.
Imagine them telling you your wait time is 1.5 hours, then someone else comes up and sits immediately. Keith left and visited Toast on Lenox, where he didn't plan on doing a review but arrived to a 2.5-hour wait time. When he politely left, the entire staff walked out and offered him a seat immediately, to which he denied again. There were videos that went viral of him in the parking lot seemingly arguing with the staff, but he was just letting them know that he didn't want to skip the line. But Keith's experiences are not just unique to him. Cardi B spoke on the subject on an IG Live.
I feel like Atlanta restaurants, they don't like to make money. I feel like they don't like people. They don't like their customers. They just don't fucking like it.
That was random.
First thing first, right? You could barely order in Atlanta restaurants. Like, you go like, hey, I would like to make an order. Oh, yeah, we don't take orders. We don't take orders. It gets to the point that I literally have to name, like, I have to tell, like, people that order food for me, like, can you just name drop my name? Because first and first, they don't do no pickup orders, they don't do deliveries, they just don't do shit.
And of course, we got some hilarious memes from this whole situation.
You walk in, let me show you how it's done. Hello, sir, how are you today?
I seen this video.
You talk like that? We talk like that, because Keith Lee is in town, bro.
That boy Keith Lee in Atlanta now. Hey, y'all little bougie at restaurants, y'all better get on your goddamn Zoom.
That's all I'm saying.
Hey, milk and honey. Uh-huh. See, that was
already got caught.
Give me attitude.
That's why your license told no.
Told y'all my partner was just down the street.
Hey, yo, man, Mikey, keep out of school. Keep playing with him.
Car.
Although most people were understanding of Keith's frustration with these ATL businesses, others,
Ocho?
Like ex-football player Chad Ochocinco, thought he was trying to...
I thought Ochocinco was like a fucking rapper. I don't really know. Or a comedian.
Tear down black-owned businesses.
I don't like the critiquing of our restaurants and having people...
But he know he was wrong.
Talking bad about our goddamn businesses and... Okay. Like, dude, you know how hard it is
and I get it. Ocho.
For us to Ocho. Even get in the food industry. What are the qualifications of being a food critic?
Go to a restaurant and do you like the food? Did you like the customer service? What was it like? Yes. What was the wait time like? That's all you gotta do.
At the end of the day, Keith just gives his honest opinion and experience, but he implores everyone to try for themselves. If he is too positive, his opinion will hold no weight. If he is
it's really a double-edged sword, if you ask me.
Negative, he will be seen as destructive. There will always be haters. However, broadcasting his opinion to 14 million followers will, without a doubt, prevent a lot of people from trying a restaurant. If someone I trust says, don't go somewhere to eat, I'll probably listen to them. Right. Or if I have one bad experience, I probably won't go there again. This is why some people argue that you can't have a bad day in the customer service industry. If you can't afford a bad review, then you shouldn't give bad service, especially if you are inviting a food critic to your establishment, which a lot of these restaurants do. Through all the drama, Keith found a lot of gems in Atlanta. The seafood menu, Juicy Jerk, the dining experience, which he personally tipped the owner $2,000, and Jamaican Jerk Biz, where the owner broke into tears when he walked in. He asked the owner what her sales were for the day, which was $2,600, and he paid her $3,000 for his meal. However, Keith just announced that he's on his way to Houston to do paid her $3,000 for his meal. However,
nigga, ew! Who is eating this? Send this shit straight to...
Keith just announced that he's on his way to Houston to do a food tour, and restaurant owners are trembling. In just 10 months of fame, Keith has helped...
Like you really don't gotta... Just make a fool good and don't... And treat everybody equal. It shouldn't be that hard.
...hundreds of businesses, raise tens of thousands of dollars for charity, and continues to spread love and positivity during a time where we need it the most. Maybe from here he will start a food review show, or a cooking show. Or maybe an app for restaurants all around the country that he recommends. As long as he remains the positive and wholesome man social media knows and loves, they will support whatever endeavor he chooses. Finally, the internet made the right person famous.